but the most basic way to be a socially responsible business owner or business person is to grow every person that works for you. To commit yourself that that person will improve their resume based on their skill set and their knowledge set and the mentorship you provide them every single year. If there's been somebody working at your practice and you can't tell me that you've improved their capabilities in the last 1 or 2 years, that's your starting point. Because when I look at companies that really make a difference in the world, companies that are really green, they grow everything in their path. They mentor their suppliers instead of berating them for a lower price. They elevate their employees and give them confidence and a feeling of self-worth instead of asking, what have you done for me lately? And they take the people at work and capture their dreams with training and development programs, and they help them grow into the future.
Tim Sanders offers a powerful message. Your people are the center of business and leadership development. From 2001 through 2004, he served as Yahoo's chief solutions officer. A survivor of the internet boom and bust, Sanders created and led the Yahoo Value Lab, an in-house think tank which delivered futuristic insights on technology and human behavior, including surprising studies on how email culture affects business.
Now, when you have an event that's on the weekend, I understand you got to talk to each other, but generally speaking, I've gone out and participated with Pitney Bowes in the biggest study ever done on email etiquette. And did you know that when people get 2 in the morning emails from you, or 15 emails on their Saturday day off, there is a statistical probability that they will log on to monster.com or Hot Jobs and post their resume. And you will certainly invade what we call the healing process. The healing process is when they're not at work. They go home, they heal. And for some of you folks, come on, you got to stop these late night emails. I call it sipping and sending. It's the business version of drinking and dialing. We've also learned that if you start sending late night emails, behavior changes and people start to check their email at home. Not good for relationships, but even worse for sleep patterns. You start getting disturbing emails from somebody at 10 or 11 at night and you learn to check that late, right before you go to bed, you're going to come down with something I call late night math. You know what I'm talking about. Late night math is when you're laying in bed and you can't stop thinking because work is on your mind. And so what you do is you look over at that LED clock next to your head and you start to do the following mathematical calculations, don't you? You go, it's 2:08 in the morning. If I fall asleep in the next 7 minutes, I will still get 3 hours and 45 minutes of sleep. So quality of life is not just attaboy, but that compassion for people that spreads and creates a great company to work for.
Tim is the best-selling author of 3 books, including the New York Times and international bestseller Love is the Killer App, How to Win Business and Influence Friends. His 2nd book, The Likeability Factor, was the basis for a PBS special. His 3rd book, Saving the World at Work, was named one of the top 30 business books of 2008 by Executive Soundview. His work is frequently featured in media outlets like The Today Show, ABC News, The New York Times, The Wall Street Journal, and Fast Company. Tim has made a name for himself as an innovator, a marketing expert, and a people skills guru, whose advice includes how to form better business relationships through networking.
Because I believe networking is a gift. When you put 2 people together that should meet and get out of the way so they can make something happen in their life, you make a difference and you grow that person and you grow their power. Listen to me, your network is your net worth. Elmer Letterman is thought of as the most successful life insurance networker in history. Started his business out in the early 1930s with very little money, and the Great Depression didn't make things much better. But he had a simple branding program. Every Friday, 50 weeks out of the year, he would host a networking lunch at the Manhattan Four Seasons. So during the week, he would prospect for subjects. So he would take people like, what's your name? Stephen. Stephen has an idea for a restaurant. He wants to leave the big restaurant, and he wants to create his own restaurant on Broadway. You're one of his customers, and he knows about your dream, and he thinks you've got talent and potential. And what's your name?
Vivian?
Vivian is a successful bank in New York City that Elmer trusts, admires,
and believes will get your value proposition. Darren, nice to meet you. You are a construction executive, well known for your ability to deliver an on-time, on-budget, beautiful facility. He invites the three of you, and he begins a conversation about credibility and opportunity, and at 12:45, he pays the bill and leaves. He never brings a brochure. He never brings a business card. You could look at him and say, I want to buy more insurance from you, and he would look at you like you'd slapped him in the face and say, you can call my partner next week. I am here because I want the three of you to meet. And he did this Friday system, 50 weeks out of the year for a decade. By 1939, he had set a record for policy assets per capita that stood till the mid-50s. How did he do it? Well, come on, do the math, right? Do the math of reciprocity. You take three people, and you put them together. You get out of the way. When you open your restaurant, I don't ask for a table. I don't ask for a meal. I don't even take credit. Now, what do you get after 10 years? You get a sea of people in one local community that will not do business with anybody but Elmer Letterman. Goodwill is the original viral marketing.